Hello everyone, Vanakkam and welcome to Kitchen Secrets. This is Vashni with you. Today we are going to see the secrets behind making chole or chana masala.
2 cups of cooked chickpeas, 1 inch of ginger and 7 garlic cloves, 1 pinch of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of garam masala, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 tablespoon of oil, whole spices, 1 tablespoon of dry kasturi methi, 1/4 teaspoon of amchur powder, 1 roughly chopped onion, 1 roughly chopped tomato. Let's start with the pre-preparation. Now in a mixer jar, we'll add ginger, garlic, 1 onion chop. Let's make onion ginger garlic paste. Onion paste is ready now. Let's transfer this into a bowl. In the same mixy jar, I'm going to add the tomato and make a puree out of this. Tomato puree is now ready. Also, you can transfer this tomato puree into a bowl. Now, let's start with the preparation of chana masala. In a white pan, first I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of oil. I'm going to first add the whole spices. Once it is roasted little bit, first I'm going to add the onion to it and mix it nicely. After 2 minutes, I'm going to add the tomato puree. Mix it well. It has been 3 minutes now. It is nicely boiling now. Now it's time to add the spices. Coriander powder, red chili powder, turmeric powder, required salt. Mix it well. This is the basic onion tomato puree and can be used in many recipes like bindi masala, aloo matar masala and much more. Now this onion tomato puree is ready. You can see the oil is coming out a little bit. This is the consistency that we are looking for. Now it's time to add the cooked chickpeas. Mix it well. To adjust the consistency, you can also add some water if you wish to. Let this chickpeas boil in the onion tomato gravy at least for 10 minutes to absorb all the spices. After 10 minutes, I am going to just mash some chickpeas to thicken the gravy. Now it's time to add the other spices. Kasturi methi, garam masala, amchur powder. Mix it well. Finally, I'm going to add 1 cup of water and let this come to a boil. Here, I have not added the store-bought chole masala as the whole spices we used here will give a nice flavor to this chole masala. Now, it's time to turn off the flame. This chana masala goes very well with chapati, poori or even with the plain bread. Do try this at your home and leave me the comments how it turned out. In the meanwhile, don't forget to subscribe to my channel.